Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 17 Beta 1 has been out for a couple of weeks at this point. We're anxiously awaiting Beta 2 with more new features, but there's even more features that have been found in Beta 1 since the initial What's New video and even the follow-up. So it's a pretty feature-packed update. We'll talk about that, we'll also talk about some app updates and the overall experience as I've been using this full-time on my 14 Pro Max and iPad Pro for a couple of weeks. We'll talk about your experience as well, where in the YouTube community poll I ran a couple weeks ago, we have 20,000 votes and 441 comments. I've gone through most of the comments to see what the overall experience is like for everyone. So we'll talk about some of the comments toward the end and the experience as well. But the first thing is, there were updates to some apps this past week, and Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, or the iWork suite of apps from Apple, got some pretty big updates. It's free if you have these apps installed. You can just install them, and this works on iOS, iPadOS, and macOS. And you'll see here with Numbers, it says they've added scalable vector graphics and other things as well. Under Keynote, it will now use ProRes video, so you can insert ProRes and again, SVGs. And then again, under Pages, we have some new updates as well, where you can start writing in notes, then open your note in Pages to continue editing with powerful design and layout features. Lots of really nice updates here with SVGs and even more. So this is something a lot of people have wanted and I think will be very helpful. Now, as far as new features, well, let's take a look at some of those. As when you set wallpapers, if we go in here and maybe we go to set a wallpaper, you'll see if we select the wallpaper from today, if I pull down sort of as I'm zooming in, it fades the top out into black. So you can actually bring this down to recenter it. You can make it larger, but it sort of fades the top out into black. And it's just a nice touch if you wanted to sort of extend a photo that doesn't typically fit there properly. So that's something that's really nice. Also, I don't know if this is necessarily a feature, but something I appreciate. When I change focus modes from here, sometimes it doesn't change the wallpaper anymore. Oftentimes I would switch this, it would jump to a different wallpaper. I want it to actually stay on the wallpaper I have, and it seems like this is either going to be a feature in the future with a switch, or maybe it's just the way it works now. But this is much better than we had before. So it seems to work even after a reboot. I can switch different focus modes, and it doesn't jump between different wallpapers, so that's really nice. Widgets has an update also. So if we slide over here and we take a look at a widget here on this iPhone, this actually has 16.5 on it. And you'll see here with the actual stock widget that the new one has some up or down arrows depending on how the stock is doing overall. So it's a small update, but it is something they've changed. Now, if we go ahead and connect our CarPlay device, when you're using Apple CarPlay, we'll give it a second here to load. And if we go to send a new message, we can do this via Siri, or we can just tap on it and go into it directly. You can see the overall UI has changed. So we have a big button for each one of these where we can cancel, change, or send. So it's an all new UI that looks a little bit better and is easier to press if you're driving. Under settings, if we go down to Face ID and passcode, if we change our passcode, you'll see here it says after you go to enter your new passcode, you've put in the previous one, it says for the next 72 hours, you can use your previous passcode to reset your new passcode if you forget. So you'll actually have to go to your passcode options, tap forget, then it'll let you put in the old one. Back in settings, if we go down to passwords, and if we go into a password, and you'll see on the left, I have iOS 16.6 betas. On the right, I have iOS 17. If we tap on edit, we now have the option to modify the title at the top. We can't do that in previous versions, so we can't modify the title at the top here. In iOS 17, we can. We can change it to anything we want. If we go into settings and then scroll down, go to control center, scroll down again, you'll see there's a new option for ping my watch. Once we have that added, if we go into the control center and we have an Apple Watch, tap on it to locate your watch. So it makes a noise. If I pick it up and look at it, it will stop pinging and it will stop its noise. So it's a nice way to figure out where it is if maybe you left it somewhere and you can't find it. Now, if you go into a FaceTime call or another call, maybe using Zoom or something else, there's some new options there or some new features. And when you're in a FaceTime call, if we go to the control center in the upper left, we have video effects. If we go into this, we have a new dialogue here that allows us to turn these on or off. We have the studio effect. We'll turn it on and now we can adjust the intensity of it if we tap on the three dot menu. So you have that option. You'll see the intensity change there. And we also have the same for portrait mode. So if I enable that, we can adjust the background blur. And here it has a little f-stop icon, so we can adjust that as needed. We also have the option for reactions, where we have those new reactions. If we give a thumbs up, It's not working all the time. I can never get this to work, but reactions should work. If you give a thumbs up, should give reactions, fireworks, and things like that in the background. So hopefully that works a little better in the future. I know some people have said they've already got it working. Now, also, if you're in a call with someone, maybe with a Zoom call, it will now let you know if you're muted. So maybe you're talking to someone and you actually have the phone muted. Let's see if we have it here. We already have this muted, but if you're trying to speak, it actually will let you know that, hey, you're muted. You need to unmute that. And that will work across Zoom and every other app that uses video. So that's something that's really nice when you're on a call or on video and you're trying to speak. One thing I saw the other day and thought was really nice, if we go into Safari and maybe we search for the weather, you'll see that it actually brings over the weather from the weather app right in the top of your search bar. Tap on it, it will open up the weather app right in here. So it's a quick way to get to the weather app, even if you don't want to actually have it on your home screen. You can search for it and it will just show up and give other options, of course, as well. Now, also, if we go into standby mode, this is a new mode that you can place this on a stand or have it charging. There's a couple things to note as far as that goes. Now, if you have an Apple MagSafe charger or a third party charger, and maybe you place your iPhone on it with standby mode. So we'll just lock the screen here. Give it a second. There we go. It should take a second to switch over to standby. Sometimes it takes just a moment. We'll give it a second. It'll switch. There we go. And you can see we have the clock, we have the weather, the charge status. Now, if we take this off of this MagSafe charger, and then we actually place it on this MagSafe charger over here, again, we'll give it a second. It actually remembers what the last display you had on here was. So you can switch through and it will actually remember it as you switch from room to room. That's a really great feature, and I don't think I've heard anyone mention it elsewhere. If we go into a note or any place we're entering text, if we press down, the actual magnifier is much larger this time around. So that's a nice change if it was hard to see before. And then if we go to actually insert something, we tap and then we slide over, tap on insert, we have the option to insert contacts and passwords now. So that's something that they've updated that just allows you to put that right into your notes or wherever you're typing. Within photos, they've updated search to help you search videos as well. So I put in videos and then I saw 171. That's actually how many miles are remaining on my truck that I was charging. But if we go into this, this isn't just a photo, it's a video, and it found it in the exact moment that I searched for it in. So that's something you can search directly in videos for text and anything else. And if we go into a live photo, tap the icon in the upper left to see live, loop, bounce, or long exposure. The icon has been updated there. So you'll see here where we have icons next to each one of them where we didn't before. So on the left is iOS 16.6 beta. So they've just added an icon for every one of these. Now, if we bring in the iPad, there's a couple features I wanted to mention here as well. So if we go into the iPad, I'll just connect it to the Magic Keyboard. Now you could connect this to any keyboard, but one thing I wanted to show you is if you're using Stage Manager, we'll just turn it on here. And if we hold down a certain key combination, so if we hold Shift on the keyboard and then we click any app, so maybe podcasts, that will automatically add it to Stage Manager. So maybe we'll do that again with Logic Pro. It will add it to Stage Manager. Again, Final Cut Pro, it adds it automatically. So that's something that's really nice that you can add or just close it and get rid of it. So it's great that they've added that feature. It's much easier just to bring something into that than clicking and dragging. Also, if we go into our settings, within settings here, let me get out of Stage Manager. Let's take off the Magic Keyboard. And within settings, if we go to Siri, under Siri and search, and it activated as I said that, there we go. Let's go back in. Under Siri and search, you'll see that we have a new option for Siri in calls. So that's something that's new that they've added to the iPad, where we've had that on the iPhone for a little while. Also, we have multiple timers on iPhone and iPad now. So if we find the clock app here, wherever I've put it, I've probably already passed it, but let's go to clock. There we are. If we want to go into timers and start a new one, we can do that. We can also add another one and we can start up to 500 timers. So we can have 500 going simultaneously if you want to actually have those running. On watchOS 10, there's a couple things worth mentioning as well. So if we go to our apps, I typically use this list view that's alphabetical, but I know many people like the grid view. If we go to the grid view with watchOS 10, we can use the digital crown to scroll up and down through our apps. Of course, you can still use your finger to do that, but you can scroll up and down that way. Now, as far as iOS 17 beta 1 and its overall stability, it's still pretty good for most people, but there's still some issues with it. It's an early beta, but it's fairly surprising at how good it is for an early beta. Basically, most things are working, even banking apps are working. So that's a big positive. Usually in previous versions, iOS 15, iOS 16, early betas, even all the way up to the release, they just wouldn't work because Apple changed so much, it had to have an update through the App Store. So that's working. Personal voice actually is finally working for me. It took some time. I'll just show it to you really quick. We'll just hit this three times, the power sleep wake button, and then we'll go to live speech. And you can see we can type to speak. So I can say, go into my phrases, and this is what it sounds like. Well, let's turn it up. We'll do that one more time.
Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech. Today we are going to take a look at all of the changes with accessibility in iOS 17.
So it sort of sounds like me, but it's not 100% like me. So that's something that's a little bit different, that's took a few days, and I found that I actually had to charge either via MagSafe from Apple or use the Lightning connector, then it would process. If I actually used a wireless Qi charger, it just wouldn't work. Maybe it just wanted too much power. There's still some bugs in iOS 17, of course, as it's an early beta, and a few things in particular have been a little bit of a pain. When I'm in Messages, sometimes the keyboard will just overlay everything and I can't get rid of it. Other times it just disappears entirely. So there's still some issues here and there. Notifications is still an issue for whatever reason here. If we go up, you'll see it just sort of jumps in. There we go. And I'm not sure why it keeps doing that, but there's definitely some issues there. Stickers still don't work for me properly if I try and set my own sticker. So if I go in and then we'll go to the new icon here, I definitely think they're going to update some of these icons. They just don't look right. But we'll go into stickers here, add a new sticker. If we try and add a sticker from a wallpaper here, let's see if it actually works. Usually it just sits on this screen and doesn't go anywhere. So it still seems to be broken for me. Now, crossfade is apparently working for quite a few people in Apple Music, but it just doesn't work when you go into settings. So if you go into settings, you go down to music, it crashes every time. I would expect this to be fixed with beta 2, I hope, but going into music and playing songs, they will oftentimes crossfade into one another. Also, live wallpaper doesn't work for me, although it's working for some of you. Sometimes messages aren't going through or being received properly. Also, some of the accessibility features that are new don't seem to work particularly well. Sometimes they work, sometimes they don't. In particular, the new one where we can do detection mode and actually detect things such as maybe what we're pointing at. You'll see it won't even turn on right now. So there's some issues with it. Sometimes it works, sometimes it freezes up. As you can see, the image is frozen. So it's problematic. They'll fix it. It's early on. So that's just something I wanted to mention. Also, some people have said that notes are getting deleted. I haven't found this to be an issue for me, but some people are seeing their notes go away. So that leads me to, should you install this yet? And I know a lot of people are, as the developer beta is now free. If you sign up, I would still wait for the public beta. It's way too early to install this on your main device, unless you know that you can go back using a computer. So there's definitely some issues with it. I would really hold off on this. The same is true also with iOS 16.6 beta 3. I'd probably just wait until the public version is out, as that should be fairly soon. As far as iOS 16.6 beta 4 or release candidate, I would expect that either next week or it could be the following week. We don't know what kind of cycle Apple's on yet with that. But as far as iOS 17 beta 2, we can probably expect that as soon as next week. Now, last year, they released it on the 22nd of June, beta 2. They released it on June 24th with iOS 15 beta 2. So we could see it at the end of next week or the following week. We don't really know yet. We'll have to wait and see, but hopefully it's sometime next week and we'll have more features and changes and visual changes and more typically with those. Now, as far as overall performance of this, it's been okay. Performance, I don't think, is really much of an issue other than things with stickers and stuff not working with magnifier. In general, it seems to work okay. The heat of the device is manageable, it's staying fairly cool, and you can see with the thermal camera, we're at about 89 degrees Fahrenheit, so it usually hangs around 85 to 90. That's not very warm, you'll see it just went up a little bit, but in general, it's pretty good. You'll see if we go back, we're at 32.9 to 33 degrees Celsius. So in general, it's pretty good. It's doing all right. It doesn't feel very warm. And I think it's doing a good job managing the device itself. However, when we talk about battery life, that's been pretty terrible for me. If we go into settings and we go down to battery health and charging, I'm down to 93%. This is dropping faster than I've ever seen before because battery life has been terrible and I've had to charge it so often. I'm at 210 charge cycles, as you can see here, as far as Coconut Battery says, and I've never had a phone go below 100% until about late August at this point, or mid-August. Usually it doesn't happen for me. I've had every single iPhone. I've charged them all the exact same way. When we got MagSafe, I use a MagSafe charger that's certified. It's not a problem. It manages the heat. And I've never had an issue just with this phone. And the only difference really is iOS 16 betas and iOS 17 have had a lot of battery or bugs that way. As far as the last 10 days here, as far as battery life, you'll see I used almost 100% of my battery yesterday and only used 3 hours and 9 minutes of screen active time, 7 hours and 7 minutes of screen idle time. Today I've used 3 hours and 17 minutes and used 50% of my battery. So it does vary, but I'm usually getting about 3 to 5 hours of screen on time, which is terrible for a 14 Pro Max. I'm also experiencing pretty poor battery life on the iPad. And if we bring in the iPad Pro, again, this is a 12.9 M2. If we go to battery, I find that I have to charge this quite a bit now. So if we go over the last 10 days, 3 hours and 50 minutes, today, 1 hour and 14 minutes. So maybe 4 hours total, but I had to charge it since yesterday to today. So I'm seemingly having to charge it almost every day and getting about 4 hours max of screen on time, maybe 5 if I'm lucky. Again, it's just not very good. So hopefully they fix that. Performance seems to be great, but battery life, being an early beta, it's not too much of an issue, and I'm not too concerned about the battery. I can always have them swap it, and I'll get a new phone just to review for the videos like this later on, of course. But it is a bit disappointing, and if, again, you're wondering if you should install the beta, if you're worried about your battery health, I probably wouldn't. It's not the beta, it's just that the beta is using so much power that you'll have to charge more often, causing more cycles and causing that to come down. Now let's go ahead and take a look at a few more of your comments. There's not a whole lot more to say as we wait for beta 2. Matt Kalen's Speed Up Song said iOS 17 beta 1 got more stable than even 16.5. I didn't expect that. Isaac's Tech Reviews said, overall, iOS 17 has been pretty stable and usable. I downgraded back to iOS 16.5 after about a week of usage of iOS 17, as the battery life I was getting on iOS 17 just wasn't long enough for my needs. I still have watchOS 10 downloaded though, and it's great. That guy, 7608, said, there are some bugs, not as buggy as past betas. I've only rebooted my phone once this past week, but so far, so good. Can't wait for this to hit the public. So the public beta probably will be out in July, as Apple has said. It could be a week before. And so that's everything so far with iOS 17 beta 1. It seems to be feature packed, like I said, and there's much more in it than we realized. Very small changes, but a lot of nice refinements, and hopefully Apple's finally focusing on stability. Let me know your experience and if you're going to try out the public beta in the comments below. And of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.